Thank you, sir, for being here.
Thank you.
It's very kind of you.
Very nice.
Now, in the past, you were known as the CEO of Hyderabad. Now, Hyderabad doesn't belong to you anymore. Do you have any regrets?
Why should I? That is my brainchild. With the passion, I developed Hyderabad. I am proud of that city. Whenever I see that city, I am very happy. One should have enjoyment in life about their fulfillment. Even if you see Hyderabad, International Airport, Outer Ring Road, Microsoft, high-tech city, total Cyberabad, these are all the things I have visualized and then I had developed. Today, Hyderabad has become knowledge hub, knowledge state. I'm very happy for that. Now as a matter of fact, bifurcation. People lost confidence. Everybody thought so much of injustice for us. There is no systematic approach for bifurcation. No capital. Income is very less. No education institutions. No industries. People at one stage, they are all afraid. What is going to happen for us? From that stage I started, 2.5 years. When I gave an appeal to my people for new capital, I am very happy, 33,000 acres of land, all political parties tried to create problems. Even then they stood as a one unit. They support you.
Do you think that the people of your state, present-day Andhra Pradesh, still carry this feeling that the bifurcation was unjust, improper?
Still, not only still, forever they are having that feeling. There is no scientific approach for bifurcation.
And do you subscribe to this?
No, they agreed. Even Congress High Command agreed. We had done for political gains. Even you know how people responded. Congress party's history in Andhra Pradesh is 125 years. Even when after emergency, only two states Congress has won. One is Andhra Pradesh.
Now they have been wiped out.
Only 2% or 1%.
So looking back, this bifurcation should not have happened. Like it would have been best avoidable. Do you think so?
No, what I am saying, bifurcation happened. Now, to go back, there is no meaning. We should not discuss about it. According to me, how to take forward the issue now.
But do you miss Hyderabad, your creation, your baby?
No, why should you think like that? Always it has to move forward. People should have a bright future.
So
they are all people of our state only, Telugu community only, and also Indians. I always wish them best.
So looking forward, looking towards your future, do you now see yourself as CEO of Amravati?
No, what I am saying, I will be best custodian of the people. Short term, medium term, long term. Any person has to think, one is I have to mitigate the problems of people today. I have to plan for future. That is exactly what I am doing today. Welfare. Whenever there are some sections which are all in distress, I have given a remedy for them. First time in the country, 24,000 crores I have given loan waiver for the farmers. Around 90 lakh women, they are all self-help groups, they are having a problem. I have given 10,000 rupees for each member, that means around 10,000 crores. This is one way infusing the capital and also creating confidence. Whenever you are in distress, always your mind will work for negative.
True.
You are positive now because you don't have problem. This is where I am thinking differently. For a good economy also, we have to carry people, we have to keep them happy, we have to create confidence.
I had personally visited, like when we came down to meet you, Amravati is just, apart from that temporary secretariat, is just a patch of huge patch of barren land, like you are building from the scratch. Now, it will take years and years for a new capital to come up, right? So why did you choose Amravati?
Not only years. Always in India, if you see from the beginning, unplanned, unscientific towns we have built. Sometimes there are some slums emerging over a period of time. Then sometimes we may improve slums or we may not improve. And also sometimes expansion of the city, that also not planned. These are all the things I have seen. First time I have done scientific way in Hyderabad. We had two cities, Hyderabad and Secunderabad. Then I planned Cyberabad city. It is a planned city. Today, Cyberabad is the heart of the Telangana state. All income is coming. Earlier, Abids was the major economic center. Today, not Abids. It is Cyberabad. So, this is what I am saying, leaders always visualize what is going to happen.
So, you see a great opportunity for Amravati because you can start from the scratch and plan it well.
Greenfield city, and also one of the best dynamic city, Krishna River is going. There is three cities now, two cities, two municipalities. One is Guntur, one is Vijayawada, one is Tenali, one is Mangalagiri. There are so many villages up there. Very beautiful land, and also if I develop, that will be the best. I can plan from scratch, very good roads I can plan, and also I can plan blue and green, greenery, yeah. One of the best greenery I can create.
Agreed, sir, but don't you feel that you have been let down by the central government? They promised you special category status during the bifurcation. And then it has not been delivered.
Now they are saying they will give special package. Right. What are all the benefits you can get from special status? All benefits will be extended. That I am.
But they have not yet defined the quantum, right?
Quantum, what they are saying, what are all the benefits you are getting from a special status? We will give all the benefits in the name of a package. That is what they promised me. I asked them, make it a legal sanctity also, you give it.
Okay.
That they are working.
So how long do you think that this will take? Like,
no, immediately they have to do. Now NABARD, they have given money for Polavaram. Almost all they agreed. Around first instance, they are giving 3,000 crores roughly. So that is going on now.
But then this might cost you politically, right? Because the special category status has a different connotation.
As a wise politician, I have to take forward. People are having confidence on me. Only simple reason, I am a matured politician. And also, I can do better than anybody in the state. Their life will be safe in my hands. That is how they have government.
But your political opponents might be up to some mischief here.
Always, right? Political opponents will create a problem. They are meant for that. If I do everything right also, they won't appreciate me. If they appreciate, they will lose the ground. So it is a continuous process. But what I am doing, I have to communicate to the people. People are having confidence. Then I have to deliver. That is important.
BJP, you are an ally of BJP. They are your friends. But in Andhra Pradesh, is there an undercurrent of tension? Like, maybe politically, it may not be politically correct for you to say. But there has been some speculation that there has been some tensions within the two, TDP
and... No, I don't think so. All these things, in a family, in a party, in an organization, always there are some...
Issues.
How to sort it out, that issues?
No, because to think logically, if BJP has ambitions in Andhra Pradesh, if they have to grow, they can grow only at your expense, right?
These are all things, if I do well, nobody can do anything. If I won't do well, even I am with BJP, even my opponents will have an advantage. Even there is no opposition will emerge. So these are all our own performance.
You seem to be pretty confident about winning, being re-elected next time. And you are doing a wonderful job. That is what we are given to understand. Last time, what went wrong? Like, what are the lessons you have taken?
No, last time, not one or two. I was totally confident. I was ahead of times. There was some drought, there are some more problems, political problems also. All these things have created problems.
Was it your overemphasis on technology, IT,
Not only that, IT has given very good advantage for the state. At that time, people might not have understand that that's okay. What I am saying always, we have to carry people, we have to communicate. At that time, even economic reforms, our state is number one. No other state has done economic reforms also. Variety of problems created a problem. For my defeat, it is contributed. Today, I am analyzing everything. Now, today, you are seeing so many states are got re-elected. Even Madhya Pradesh, Orissa, even Chhattisgarh,
yeah.
Even some other states, they are Gujarat, everywhere. Winning the elections is not a big problem, according to me. Only problem, I have to do what I am expected to do, or with my vision is very clear, focus. I want to fulfill all these things.
So your emphasis this time, apart from technology and IT and all that, will be people welfare.
Welfare, development, empowerment. And also weaker sections, how to strengthen them continuously. Not one-time job.
So one last question. You see yourself as the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh or the CEO of Andhra Pradesh?
Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh and well-wisher of the people of Andhra Pradesh. For every family, I wanted to be head of that family.
The elder of that family.
To help them, to coordinate, to empower, to support them. Whenever there is a problem, I want to help them, rescue their problems. That is where I am working.
Thank you, sir. Very kind of you.
Thank you.